Yeah, typically brick is able to do well or better than the average cultivar in the conditions that 2012 is a great illustration of, where it got hot after it quit raining. So in that instance, the materials that finish the job of producing their grain as early as possible are usually at an advantage. The problem is, how do you predict that? So in 2009, 10, and 11, as examples, that really isn't what took place, but in 2012 it was, again, a great example. Now 2013, I guess the jury's out. So what I always like to sometime in my discussions mention is that the best way to go about this is to, when you can, pick two or three cultivars and plant them in some of your ground. I guess just spread the risk around by doing that when you can. I know not everybody can, but it seems like there were about three things that I wanted to hit on, but I'm gonna reserve one for later. And probably so that we can eat, I think I'll just skip it altogether. But if you're interested in what needs to, in my opinion, take place with the wheat checkoff and the wheat commission, please find me as you're eating or after you eat or sometime. And I've got some information provided by the wheat commission that I can share. And I've got some firsthand experience on what's taking place. And that is consistent reductions in our research budget that I think are important for everyone to know about, but it will take a while for me to discuss that, and I know that we're hungry. So if you're interested, please find me later on. So that leaves two things to talk about. The first of which is, while I was listening to Nathan on his last discussion, I was looking at the numbers on the handout that each of you have, and I couldn't find any instance where Select was not as good or worse than Briggs. So what I've always said, because I developed Select, was, and actually Select has a Briggs as one of its parents. So my contention has always been, if you like Briggs, you should love Select. And the numbers bear that out very well. Briggs was released at a time and in a place where the way that it took off was just phenomenal, not in South Dakota alone, but the three-state region. Everybody knows about Briggs, and everybody knows that it does well, typically, and feels comfortable probably with it, and has no reason to trade or to go elsewhere and plant Select, for example. I think that's why it's hung on so long. But actually, if you talk with the wheat commissioners and others, you'll hear stories that in certain years and certain locations, the end use, specifically the dough to bread qualities of Briggs, are less than expected. So, you know, for years and years it did great, and then here comes this aberrant year, and suddenly the millers that turn the Briggs into flour to use in their bread recipes say, what the heck's happening? And it's to the point where, after that happened from over a few years and at more than a few locations, the grain buyers that the Wheat Commission hears from probably daily were saying, hey, if the elevators in South Dakota don't quit sending us Briggs, we're going to quit buying wheat from South Dakota, or we're going to severely discount it. So along with Traverse, I think that Briggs should be replaced by Forefront and Select for sure. But also, one of, or maybe both of, the experimental lines that I'm going to talk about now. So that leaves the last topic of discussion, and that is the two experimental lines. We call them right now SD4178 and SD4189. In 2011, in the fall, we released Advance and Forefront. We released two at a time because we were at the point in the program, after it was nearly 10 years that I had been there at that point, where we had one short one and one taller one. And taller one would be more typical of, you know, Briggs, Granger, Select, Brick, Traverse, and think back to my predecessors. So with the exception of Oxen, which was pretty short, and Walworth was fairly short too, there were a lot of taller materials, very similar in shape, size, stature, so on, to Briggs and Granger, and Forefront are wonderful examples. So I guess my point is, we had one that was shorter. Now, I always tell stories about when I first started in 2002, one of the first field days I went to, people were already on me about shortening the materials developed by the SDSU program. At that time, there were Knutson, Granite, some others from Westbred and AgriPro at the time they were called, that were available and did relatively well in South Dakota. They were originally developed, I think, for the Red River Valley, but they did well, and people like to see them. You know, they have very distinct rows, and they just look wonderful all year long. So I've tried, although it's taking time, to move in that direction with the breeding program. So Advance was the first of those that we've got that would fit into the different and shorter category. And then SD4178, which is right here, is the second of those that are shorter in stature. Okay, so that's the short statured one that we hope to release this fall to sort of address the desire of people to not have as much straw out in the field. Actually, there's numbers reported on the sheet that you have, so you can sort of see how it's performed. I'm probably most excited about its bacterial leaf streak resistance and lack of leaf rust susceptibility as well. So I think its capability of defending itself, you know, from various diseases is going to be relatively good. That then leaves SD4189, which is a little bit taller, and like I mentioned, Granite, from, if you think back 13 years or so, maybe you were familiar with that. It was released by, at the time they were called Western Plant Breeders. So 4189 actually looks very, very similar to Granite, except it's taller. And by being that way, it's more typical of what the SDSU program releases, which, along with being a little bit taller, also are, generally speaking, a little bit more early than the materials that might be brought down from North Dakota or brought over from Minnesota. So that's, you know, one of the hallmarks of the SDSU spring wheat program, especially with Brick and Select, is their earliness. Because, you know, as the middle part of the continent heats up, generally South Dakota is the first to feel those effects. So when we can get our spring wheat to finish up early, that's always good.